video, I'm gonna give you tips of things you have to arrange already a few weeks before you start traveling, so you don't forget to arrange very important stuff. In this video, in total, I'm gonna give 20 tips, so stay tuned and let's start. Tip number one is your passport. You have to look, of course, if your passport is still valid. And many countries, when you travel to, they require that your passport is still valid after you leave the country for still 3 or 6 months. So you also want to check if your passport is still valid. Tip number two, look if you need a visa for the country you want to travel to. It can depend on which country you come from. If you will need a visa, you can look it up online. Some visas you have to arrange far ahead. If you go to China, or like this one, I wanted a visa for Vietnam longer than 30 days. So I had to arrange it already from the Netherlands. Sometimes it can take like 4 weeks before you get your passport back with a visa in it. Many countries also do visa on arrival, which is pretty okay. But most of the times the visas on arrival are only for 30 days. So it depends how long you want to travel if you will need a visa. Going on the visa, it is very convenient if you take some extra pictures with you. You have your picture in the passport. If you still have the spare extra pictures of this one, it might be useful that you take them. Because if you come to customs service and you do a visa on arrival, sometimes the country wants a picture. If you already have them on you, it goes a little bit quicker and it's cheaper. Otherwise, you have to take a picture there and that is, of course, expensive. Tip number three, you want to arrange travel insurance and health insurance. You before you go if you need shots, vaccinations, because there are many countries that require or suggest you to do it. And some vaccinations you need like 2 or 3 shots in a row, or maybe a month before you start to travel, before it actually works. And you get a passport of your vaccinations. It's very convenient for yourself too, because you can see what shots you already got and how long they are still good for. You also have to take this one on your travel, because there are some countries that you can only get into the country or leave the country to the next destination if you have this one on you, that you can prove that you actually have the shots. Also, an extra tip on medication. If you have medication that you really need, go to your pharmacy or to your doctor and let them print out the whole list of your medication and take that on you, and actually make sure that you have a spare one somewhere else, put it on a phone, etc. That in case you need it in a foreign country, that you can go to the pharmacy or the doctor and show that you get the right medication. Tip number five, make copies of your passport and important documents like insurance numbers, number of your bank, etc. And also a paper copy of your passport. I have most of the times 3 on me. Some hotels and countries require that you leave your passport at the front desk of the hotel, and I don't like that. Most of the times they also accept a copy of your passport if you have it. And also, when I go on the streets and I don't do anything special that day, I don't want to walk around with my original passport. Then I walk around with a copy of my passport. And I hope that if ever I got stopped by the police, that at least for the first few minutes, they accept the copy of my passport and that I can come in with the original later. Tip number six. Make sure that you have your airplane ticket or on paper, or at least email it. And a lot of air companies have now an app that actually you can help that too, that you have the QRL that they can scan it, but make sure that you have your airplane ticket. Tip number seven, book the hotel at least for the first night. Because traveling is pretty exhausting, especially already with all the preparation before, and the travel day itself can be very exhausting. So give yourself a break and book at least the first night a hotel that when you arrive at the railway station or the airport that you already have an address to go to. Tip number eight, check the weather. There are, of course, if you travel in summer, you expect that it's very warm, etc. But like if there is a cold wave or a heat wave of something, you want to know it before, so you actually know which things to pack and which type of clothes you want to take. Number 9, you want to make sure that your bank card and your credit card work in the country you go to. So I'm from the Netherlands. In Europe, we have to make sure that our cards are also working outside Europe. So if I go to America, Australia, or Asia, it doesn't matter. But look into if your bank cards are working in the country or the destination you fly to. And number 10, actually I pay most of the time everything with my credit card, because it goes so quickly and it's very easy, but I always have emergency cash on me. So I have some euros and also some dollars, and also like $1 bills, because $1 bills can be very useful if somebody helps you or you want to tip them and you don't have already the currency of the country you're traveling in. Everybody knows and appreciates a dollar. So have some emergency cash. I say like make sure that you have like a 50 or 100 US dollars a person. Number 11, if you go on a long travel, especially if you're gonna visit more countries than one, you can register at your embassy. So it's on the internet, you can register your whole trip, which countries you're gonna travel to. And if something happens in those countries, if they suddenly go to war or there's a tsunami or whatever, you get an update in your email which says that it goes from green to orange maybe, or to red. Number 12, on my phone I have an app that's called maps.me. It's very convenient for never get lost, but you have to download the cards of the destination you go when you still have internet service. So for this app and maybe for some other apps, you need internet access. So make sure that everything you need to download before that, you already did it at home. Tip number 14 is also on your phone. Look into it. If you can use your phone in the country which you're gonna travel to, if you can use it there, how much is gonna cost? Because sometimes if you travel longer, it might be cheaper and easier that you can buy a local SIM card. Most tip number 15. It's a small tip, but take your own pencil. It's very convenient that you have your pencil. If you have to fill in the forms for the hotel or for the visa, many times there are not enough pencils and then you have to wait till. Tip number 16. Some countries require an entrance fee to go into the country or an exit fee when you need to leave. Most of the times you need to pay these fees in cash. So especially with an exit fee, say like you have to pay $18, I already have put those $18 in my passport, that I know for sure that when I leave that I can pay actually the exit fee in cash, because most of the times they don't have an ATM. Tip number 17, before you start traveling, make sure that all your devices, your telephone, are fully charged already. You will not, you don't know when the next time is. So tip number 18, if you go to a tourist area and you actually sure what you want to visit, you can already buy a ticket upfront, because some popular tourist attractions, the tickets are already sold out long time before. So when I was in San Francisco, I was not able to go to Alcatraz because those tickets were already sold out like 2 months in advance. The same would be for the Anne Frank Museum in Amsterdam, or sometimes the Robben Island, the Nelson Mandela prison in South Africa. In high seasons, it can be that those tourist attractions are sold out the tickets, and it would be a pity if you come in the area and you're really looking forward to visit it and you can't because you don't have a ticket. Tip 19, I don't know all the phone numbers anymore of all my family and friends, because everybody has a cell phone and there are so complicated long numbers. So I made a list of all the important addresses, but also the important phone numbers, also from my friends and family. And I emailed it to myself, because if you lose your phone, you want to contact your family, of course. And if you have an email, you can always access your email, of course, with a password. And the last tip, of course, is all the information you have, your passport number, all your insurance numbers, your itinerary of your travel, give it to family and friends. It's actually more for their reassurance, that they feel better, but it's also nice that you have a backup plan. These were my tips that will help you in a stressful preparation time, that you can actually just make a checklist of my video, and then you can mark it what you already done, so you're sure that the most important things you have covered, and you only have to go and look forward to your travel, enjoy your travel. Watch my other videos. I have many more tips videos. You can subscribe to my channel for free, of course. And I say, let's explore this world together.